Hello and welcome back to another of my episodes of PS Crafty DIY. This time I'd like to show you how I made my branded logo using cheap Rotary toolkit from Amazon. Link at the top takes you to my full review of the kit I'm using for this project. I'm making my branding logo from this piece of brass bar that I found. Brass is fairly soft, so I should be able to carve it easily, and its thermal conductivity properties would work in my advantage too. So let's quickly sketch it out. Using a set square helps me with the straight lines and outlining the letters. Any letters I'm going to use here need to be spelled backwards and reversed in order to be facing correctly when stamped into the workpiece. So there is my reversed P, and the S is coming up. End cap of my marker pen is good enough for the round shapes. So let's begin. First I'm using a cutting disc that came in a kit to shape my corners. The trick is to let the disc do its work. Let it glide without applying any pressure. Notice I'm always stabilizing my hand by resting it on the pinky or rest my hand on its side. The speed settings that work best for me are set between 15 to 20,000 RPM. Once I'm happy with the corners, I can use the disc to do the straight lines. It's worth try gently using the disc in between the letters as well, but need to be very careful and only do a bit at a time. Now it's time to switch to diamond burr. First I'm using an inverted cone and carve the letters. Same rules apply here. Let the burr glide and do its job. Slowly do a bit at a time and keep checking the work. It looks like my masterpiece drawing is fading away, so let me quickly correct that. Still using the inverted cone, I can go over it once again and make it more pronounced by going a bit deeper. I really like this shape of a burr, it's so versatile. Let's switch to a needle point now and tidy up the edges. The diameter of the needle tip is smaller compared to the inverted cone, so I lowered the speed of the tool to 10,000 RPM. Slowly getting there, and things started getting the shape. And now to finally smooth those lines out, I use a hand file. The face of my branding logo is pretty rough, so let's sand it down. There is still plenty of room for an improvement, so I go back to the needle burr and try to make all the lines thinner. And it's not looking too bad at all, so let's sand it again. Clean it up and it's looking much better. The only thing that is left now is to try if it works as intended. The moment of truth. Let's start a blowtorch and heat it up. Here we go. Not too shabby. I'm liking this. Let's do one more. I think I'll be definitely using this to brand my work now. I just need to make a nice handle for it. Thank you very much for watching my video. Please subscribe to help me create more.